I have to pick that up now. Did you guys understand my little scene with the salty bee physics things for Unreal Engine? Yes, today we talk about that, how to use physics and simulate physics in order to add realism in our scene. Let's go. So, I made a little scene in Unreal Engine using mainly Megascan assets library through Bridge. And I've downloaded all little stones like that. And today we're gonna focus on this one and how to use physics in order to have this kind of effect here. We have three keys to understand and to master in order to use physics in Unreal Engine and to have all objects falling on the ground and like to fix them in place and use it as they are. So first, you have to make sure that your object has collision. And how to know that? You just have to select your objects and make a Control E to open the editor tab. And here, if we go to the top left hand side, you see collision. And mainly if you see remove collision, usually that means you have collision on your mesh. But make sure you can just go to show and tick the simple collision here, and you can see we have simple collision. So this is very important, guys. If you don't have simple collision, that won't work. If you don't have collision, you can just quickly create one. Let me remove this one. So let's say we don't have collision here, just go here and click on auto convex collision. Here we have convex decomposition on the bottom right side. You just can leave as it is, as default, it work. But just, in fact, if you crank this up, you will have a more precise bounding box of collision. So if you just hit apply, as you can see, we have now again our collision. Okay, so our mesh has now collision. Now we could do the second step, which is enable physics. So now we can save our stone here, close our tab, go back to our scene, select the stone here, and if you go to the details panel on the right hand side, go down to physics. Here we have simulate physics and the mass. If you don't have collision, there is another indicator that will tell you something's wrong, is that this case will be grayed out if you don't have collision. So that means it's okay, you can go further. I will activate it. My mass, I'll activate it also. I can leave it as default 100. It works great for this example. And now I will just launch a simulation in order to have what I want. So I go just on the top here. I just selected the simulate version with Alt plus S, not the selected viewport, because I just want to stay where I am and launch the simulation. And here I have my simulation. If I stop and launch another one, you can see that it is always a new one. So this is kind of the main power of the things, that it's really random. But now we have to go to the third step, which is fix the object once the simulation is done. You just have to press K on your keyboard, like key for animation. Let me just show you. So I just launch here my simulation. So it's done, I'm happy with the results. I just have to select it. And if you pay attention on the right bottom hand side, you will have a little window popping up saying that they just fix your objects. Where is it? So if I just press K, you have a saved state activated. So now if I just stop simulation, my object stays in place. And this will work even if you stop simulation in the middle. You just don't have to wait. It's all done. Let me just show you. If I launch it, I just press stop here. If I select my object and press K, I stop my simulation now. And you see my object stays in place. So now if I go back here and duplicate this time, so I can press Alt and click on one axis, it will duplicate like this. Now I can just launch my simulation here. I press again on stop because I wanted this kind of setup. And now in order to fix my objects, I have to select all of them. So this can be a little bit annoying if you have multiple objects. So what I'd advise you is to create like a folder before launching my simulation. It will be easier to select and just press K afterward. So I've here my object selected, I just press K. I have the little window here appearing. I just stop my simulation and everything is in place. Just an extra things to know about is when you're done with this kind of setup, make sure you deactivate your physics in your object, because otherwise, if you launch another simulation for another kind of set of objects, this will simulate again. Same things if you're happy with all the objects you laid out. If you make a render, at the render, everything's gonna simulate again. So make sure to deactivate all the physics in your objects that you don't want to simulate again. And here you can see, I just play around with the same workflow I just showed you. And you can have this kind of effects that is really efficient. It works great. You can add, for example, let me just show you a little cube here in order to kind of block the area you want the stone to fall apart. And you can go further. It's really a great way to use and make a realist scene and avoid placing one by one the objects. Okay guys, I leave you at work now and I will go back to work for myself also. And before, I just pick some pens on the floor leftover and see you for our next video. Ciao!